As much as we all want to have a wedding with an unlimited budget, for most of us, that is definitely not the case. My name is Sammy and I'm a wedding videographer. I've been filming weddings for a few years now and I'm actually planning my own wedding at the moment. So between my personal experience as a wedding videographer, my personal experience planning weddings, I have come up with a list of 10 things to keep in mind when planning your wedding on a budget. I want to preface this by saying that this is your wedding day and you can do whatever you want, but I hope this list will at least inspire you to think outside the box. The first tip I have is to cut your guest list. Your guest count is the biggest factor when it comes to your wedding budget. The amount of guests you have determines the amount of tables you'll need, the amount of chairs you'll need, the amount of food, drink, decorations, centerpieces, and even the type of venue that you choose. Be flexible with your wedding date. Consider a non-Saturday wedding or a wedding in the off season. Here in Northeast Ohio, where I'm from, wedding season is typically May till the beginning of November. So if you choose a wedding that's in the colder months, you'll have more availability for the venues you're looking for and also the vendors you're looking for, because you are not competing for your date with all of these other brides. Consider your wedding venue. A venue in a big metropolitan area is probably going to be more expensive than a venue in the countryside or more of a rural area. Also, think about all-inclusive venues versus more DIY venues. All-inclusive refers to wedding venues that include more than just the space. So some venues might include their catering, bar, maybe some decorations and their rentals like tables and chairs and linen. And other all-inclusive venues might even include photography and videography or a DJ or florals or a wedding cake. So just do your research and see what your venue includes. Sometimes all-inclusive venues can save you money and sometimes not. The venue that Zach and I chose actually has a room minimum, which is pretty common with all-inclusive venues. So our venue includes catering, bar, some centerpieces, and it actually includes a wedding cake too, which is really nice, along with tables and chairs. But we do have a 150 person minimum for the room that we chose. So if we don't hit that number, we will have to pay for those meals anyway. So just keep that in mind. Being the type A person that I am, when Zach and I were booking our wedding venue, we literally created a spreadsheet for every single place we looked at and included whether or not the venue had catering, bar, decorations, things like that. And if they didn't, we had an estimated cost for what we were willing to pay for that. Did the math, and that was one of the ways that we figured out which venue we wanted. Floral. Flowers are expensive, especially for weddings when you potentially need flowers for yourself, for your bridal bouquet, for your bridesmaid's bouquet, for your centerpieces, for a ceremony arch, and so much more. There are so many options for florals. Of course, you can choose the real flowers. There's also silk, wooden, fabric, and a couple others. Typically, using fake flowers instead of real ones can save you big time. Maybe use real flowers for just your bridal bouquet and a mix of real and fake flowers for your bridesmaids' bouquets or your centerpieces or other decorations where you want to include florals. If you have a florist in mind, talk to them and see what they can do within your budget. Also, remember to repurpose your ceremony flowers for your reception. And a lot of brides have used their bridesmaids' bouquets for centerpieces in their reception, so that's another huge money saver. Skip the non-essentials. For me personally, that is wedding favors, wedding programs, and a huge invitation suite. With the amount of weddings I've filmed, you would not believe how many wedding favors just get left behind. And it's really sad because these couples have spent hours and hours creating koozies or I've seen a couple do apple pie moonshine or jams and jellies or candles, and just so many of them get left behind, which is really sad. If you're really set on having wedding favors for your guests and providing them with a free meal and free booze just isn't enough, I have seen a lot more success with favors that are either usable or edible or drinkable. Wedding programs and wedding favors usually end up in the trash. I'm sorry, but it's true. Unless it's your mom or maybe your bridesmaids who are keeping it as a memento, most people are not going to keep your wedding programs or your huge invitation suite. consider having one big sign instead of a wedding favor that lists the timeline of the day or who's in the wedding party, or consider doing electronic invitations or a more simple invitation suite if you're mailing them to your guests. Again, if these things are important to you, please disregard everything I said and do what you want. If you're hiring a photographer and videographer, which I recommend you do, in my most unbiased opinion, they're some of the most important vendors for your day. Push all of your formalities of the reception to the very beginning. So the cake cutting, first dance, parent dances, bouquet toss, that sort of thing. That way you can save yourself some money by booking an 8-hour package instead of a 10-hour package. Also, unless dance photos are super, super important to you, keep your photo and video person there for maybe an hour of open dancing. Trust me, as a wedding videographer, there's only so much dancing that I can capture and only so much that's going to end up in the final video anyway. Don't upgrade your rentals. This could include tables, chairs, linens, flatware, china. Usually the basics will do the job just fine. DIY what you can. This can save you money, but sometimes not, so use it sparingly. Usually wedding professionals recommend DIYing 40% of your wedding and hiring professionals for the other 60%. Keep in mind the phrase time versus money. So do I have the time and the patience to do this project, or would I rather just save myself the headache and pay someone to do it for me? Some typical DIYs that I have seen in the past include signage, invitations, florals, decorations. I have seen brides do their own hair and makeup, and I have seen a bride's family put together a DIY dessert table, which is really, really cute. Alcohol options. So open bars are expensive, and here in the States, it can be considered tacky to expect your guests to pay for their drinks with a cash bar. So you can save yourself some money by shortening the hours that your open bar is open. You can opt for beer and wine only, and maybe cocktails during dinner. I've also seen a lot of success with signature drinks, so the bar only needs to carry that specific liquor instead of an entire collection of it. Or if you decide on a venue where you can bring your own alcohol, that is a game changer. And sometimes alcohol suppliers will let you return unopened bottles after your wedding, which is money right back in your pocket. And my final tip is to have a budget. It is so, so easy for couples to go over their budget one vendor or one decoration at a time. Before you book anything, sit down with your soon-to-be spouse and create a budget. Who is all going to be contributing to this wedding? Is it just going to be the two of you? Do you have parents or other relatives? Figure out an estimated budget and break it down by category. It is so much easier this way, I promise you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hopefully you got some useful tips out of it. Subscribe to this channel for more wedding planning tips and tricks, and to also see the wedding videos that I create with my company, Samantha Marie Videography. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram as well. I'll see you guys next time, and happy planning.